James Webb Space Telescope, so sensitive it could theoretically detect the heat signature of a bumblebee at the distance of the moon. But James Webb has multiple restrictions and time variable viewing constraints imposed by a combination of observatory safety concerns and target position in ecliptic coordinates. Launched from Guiana Space Center on December 25th using Ariane 5 rocket, the telescope will orbit the Sun 1.5 million kilometers away, 4 times farther away from Earth than the Moon, at what is called the second Lagrange point, or L2. It is incorrect to say that James Webb will be at L2, rather James Webb will orbit around L2. As of January 9, 2022, the telescope has been successfully and fully deployed. At all times during the operational phase of the mission, the James Webb Telescope and science instruments must remain shielded from the Sun. To not do so would endanger the entire functionality of the observatory. The geometry of the James Webb sunshield limits where it can point at a given time and for how long. It also impacts the observatory's ability to observe the celestial sphere at certain position angles, especially for target positions at low ecliptic latitudes. Observations that need specific orientations for a particular instrument's field of view on the sky can run into complications due to constraints on where James Webb can point relative to the Sun. The James Webb Field of Regard, FOR, is the region of the sky where scientific observations can be conducted safely at a given time. The FOR is defined by the allowed range of boresight position angles for the observatory relative to the Sun line, which must remain in the range 85 degrees to 135 degrees at all times to keep the telescope behind the sunshield. Thus, the FOR is a large torus on the sky that moves roughly 1 degree per day in ecliptic longitude, following the telescope in its path around the Sun. Over time, this annulus sweeps over the entire celestial sphere. As a result of the FOR, James Webb can observe about 39% of the full sky on any given day and can access 100% of the sky over 6 months. Observability with James Webb is very dependent on a given target's ecliptic latitude. Below 45 degrees ecliptic latitude, James Webb can observe targets in 2 visibility windows per year, centered about 6 months apart, with each window lasting at least 50 days. Above 45 degrees and below 85 degrees ecliptic latitude, the visibility windows transition to one much longer visibility period. Ecliptic latitude determines the number of days per year the targets are observable by James Webb. Also, the allowed field of view position angles on the sky available for a given target are affected by the target's ecliptic latitude. These windows and allowed position angles can be calculated for a particular target using one of the Webb target visibility tools. James Webb has a relatively small continuous viewing zone, CVZ, located within 5 degrees of the ecliptic poles. The CVZ is important for some science programs that involve monitoring throughout the year and will be useful for calibration observations. Although the roll flexibility is still about plus or minus 5 degrees, the James Webb field of view rotates around the V1 axis, boresight, through the entire available 360 degrees over the course of the year. The observatory V-axes are defined with respect to the telescope. V1 is the boresight of the telescope, V3 points away from the sun shield, and V2 is orthogonal to both of these, forming the thumb of a right-handed coordinate system. The V2 axis is pointing towards you or out of the screen, the V3 axis, projection onto the sky, referenced eastward from north, is used within the diagnostics as an instrument-independent reference frame. Here, the James Webb coordinate system is shown in the context of the field of regard. If the observatory is pointed at 90 degrees solar elongation, the V3 axis points towards the anti-sun, but as the boresight points elsewhere in the FOR, V3 moves away from the anti-sun direction. In this view, the V2 axis is pointing into the screen. This is another view to highlight the restrictions on instantaneous roll about the Bohr side, V1 axis. The amount the observatory can roll about the V1 axis is very limited due to the requirement to keep the telescope completely behind the sun shield at all times. The plus or minus 5 degrees value is only approximate, as the amount of off-axis roll allowed is actually a function of the V1 solar elongation, ranging from approximately plus or minus 3 degrees to plus or minus 7 degrees, as V1 moves from 85 degrees to 135 degrees solar elongation. Here you can see the connection between the V-axis and the James Webb focal plane. The V3 axis is the primary observatory reference axis used in operations to connect the individual instrument reference axes, or blue arrows, in the planning and scheduling system to the celestial sphere. This is especially important for any observations where the positioning of the instrument fields of view on the sky is important. Thank you for watching, make sure to subscribe, and don't forget to check other videos about James Webb Telescope on our channel.